During today's parliament session, Speaker Anita Among announced that the president has returned two tax bills which were passed by parliament recently. These are the Income Tax Amendment Bill of 2023 and the Tax Procedures Code Amendment Bill. In President Museveni's opinion, he wants parliament to reinstate the tax waiver for Bujagali hydropower project, which was rejected by the House. Last financial year, parliament rejected a request by the government to extend the Bujagali income tax waiver for more than 5 years on grounds that the taxpayer has not benefited from the exemption since it has not achieved the intended purpose of reducing power tariffs. But in his letter to the Speaker, Museveni has justified a need to extend the Bujagali tax waiver for another year.
A clause should be incorporated to provide for an extension of a 1 year corporate income tax waiver for Bujagali hydroelectric plant.
Last year, Parliament constituted an ad hoc committee chaired by the Shema Municipality MP Dickson Kateshumba, which probed operations of Bujagali and came to a conclusion to reject the request by the Ministry of Finance to gift Bujagali Energy Limited another 5 years tax waiver until the company refunds 1.2 trillion shillings it received in excess from taxpayers through the fictitious tariffs computation methods. MPs who undertook this probe have vowed to resist any attempt by the government to extend the Bujagali tax holiday.
Around, and you want now a continued waiver for Bujagali, where this government has been hemorrhaged billions of shillings, trillions of shillings of money. I can't speak on that matter beyond that, but it will be extremely unheard of, unfortunate.
Museveni also wants Parliament to reconsider a tax proposal by the government to impose a 5% tax on the gross income digital companies, which was rejected by Parliament in May this year. Museveni insists that tax on digital companies such as Amazon, Netflix, Twitter, Facebook, TikTok and other non-resident companies, as long as they are sourcing income from Uganda, should happen.
It was meant to cater for taxation of digital economies such as Twitter, Amazon, Netflix, etc. The clause related to non-residents and non-residents in Uganda, since it does not relate to residents in Uganda, as was mistakenly stated in the minority report, it should be reinstated.
The digital companies eligible for this tax include those offering online advertising services, data services, services delivered through an online marketplace or intermediation platform, including an accommodation online marketplace, a vehicle hire online marketplace, and any other transport online marketplace. MPs on the Finance Committee explained why they rejected this tax.
It felt that there was no adequate evidence to show that a study had been carried out by the Ministry of Finance to justify that particular thing. Normally, when a tax bill is proposed, there should have been what we call a regulatory impact assessment.
Now, if it says that our minority, but it carried the day because it was in the national interest, we believe the committee, we are going back to square one on this issue.
Under the same bill, Museveni wants companies that have registered losses for 5 years to pay income tax. In the wisdom of Parliament, the proposal had been rejected on grounds that taxing companies which don't make profit is a way to kill them off. But Museveni insists that the tax is necessary after 5 years of making losses consecutively.
Creates an incentive to them to overclaim losses, hence enabling them to remain in artificial loss-making positions. The measure is thus intended to limit the practice of indefinite deferral of payment of corporate tax. It should therefore be reinstated.
You are exempting people who are declaring a profit. Okay? But you are going after companies that are making losses.
You know, the law provides that they can continue for as long as possible to make losses. So what we are saying is, let's restrict it to a certain period. After 5 years, that should not be warranted again. They should be taxed.
The bills have been forwarded by the Speaker to the Committee of Finance for reconsideration. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.